Hello students, this is Ritvik Dubey, your computer teacher. In today's video class, I will discuss about pattern programming, okay? Pattern programming. Now when I say pattern programming, means we will be asked to display some patterns like this. Star, double star, then 3 stars, okay, 4 stars, and suppose 5 stars. Okay, so the question, it will be asked to write a Java program to display this pattern. Okay, in the first line 1 star will be displayed, in the second line 2 stars will be displayed, in the third line 3 stars will be displayed, in the fourth line 4 stars will be displayed, and in the fifth line 5 stars will be displayed. Okay, so this pattern programming we will do by the help of nested for loop. Okay, we will do by the help of nested for loop. Nested for loop. So before that, I am assuming that the student doesn't know about for loop and nested for loop. So before starting the pattern programming, I will discuss with you all how for loop works and how nested for loop works. Okay, let's see. Listen, let me discuss about the syntax of for loop. Syntax of for loop. Syntax of for loop. We write for, then we write initialization expression. We write initialization expression, okay? Initialization expression. We put semicolon. Then we give testing expression, okay? Then we write testing expression. Again we give semicolon and then we write updation expression. Updation expression and close the parenthesis. We give curly bracket and this part is called as the body of the for. This part is called as the body of the for loop. Body of the for loop. Is this clear? Okay, so this is the syntax of for loop. In this part, we write initialization expression. In this part, we write testing expression. And in this part, we write updation expression. This is also called as condition. Okay, this is also called as condition. And this is also called as iteration. This is also called as iteration. Okay. Now, let me give you one example. Example. For int I is equal to 1. I less than equal to 3 and then I plus plus. Okay, let me display system dot out dot println. Okay, let me display the value of I. Let me display the value of I. Let me display the value of I. So this is the example. So this part is called as the initialization expression. This part is called as the testing expression. And this part is called as the updation expression. Okay. Now, first of all, the initialization expression is executed. First of all, the initialization expression is executed. So, this is the rough work. What is the initial value of I? The initial value of I is 1. Then the control goes to the testing expression. Then the control goes to the testing expression. Here it checks I is less than equal to 3. What is the testing expression? I is less than equal to 3. So what is the value of I? It is 1. 1 is less than equal to 3? Yes, 1 is less than equal to 3. If the condition or if the testing expression gives true, then the control moves within the body of the loop. So system.out.println file. So suppose this is the output screen, okay? This is the output screen. System.out.println file. Okay, let me. Yes, this is the output screen. Suppose this is the output screen. System.out.println I. What is the value of I? The value of I is 1. So let me write here. Okay, then the control goes to the updation expression. I plus plus. So I plus plus means the value of I will be incremented by 1 and it will become 2. Then the control will move to the testing expression again. Okay, it will check whether the current value of I is less than or equal to 3. So what is the value of I? 2. 2 is less than or equal to 3. The answer is true. If the answer is true, then the control will again move to the body of the for loop and it will print the current value of I. What is the current value of I? It is 2. So 2 will be displayed. Then again the control will go to the updation expression I plus plus. So 2 will become 3. And then the control will go to the testing expression. I is less than or equal to 3. What is the current value of I? It is 3. So 3 is less than or equal to 3. Yes. See, here two conditions are there. Okay. 3 is less than or equal to 3. No. But 3 is equal to 3. Yes. Okay, so if any one condition is true, the final result will be true. So 3 is less than or equal to 3? Yes. Okay, true. So the control will move again to the body of the for loop. It will print the value of I. What is the value of I? The current value of I is 3. So 3 will be printed. Okay, then the control goes to the updation expression. That is I plus plus. I plus plus means it is 4. Then the control goes to the condition part. What is written in the condition? I is less than or equal to 3. What is the current value of I? It is 4. 4 is less than or equal to 3. Now see. 4 is less than 3? No. 4 is equal to 3? No. So it is false. Okay, false. So once it is false, the control will come out of the body of the for. So this is the final. Okay, this is the final output 1, 2 and 3. Okay, 1, 2 and 3. Clear? Okay, so this is how for loop works. Okay, this is how for loop works. Now listen. Now let me discuss about working of nested for loop. Okay, working of nested for loop. What is the syntax? First of all, let me tell you the syntax of nested for loop. Okay, syntax of nested for loop. What is the syntax? For, then IE means initialization expression. Okay, then testing expression, then updation expression. Okay, then inner for loop, initialization expression, testing expression and updation expression. Okay, then this is the body of the inner for loop. Okay, Is this clear? So what is this? This is called as the inner for loop. This is called as the inner for loop. Okay? And this is called as the outer for loop. This is called as the outer for loop. Okay? Is this clear? Now let me give you the example. For int I is equal to 1, I less than equal to assume 3 and I plus plus. Okay, I is equal to 1, I less than equal to 3 and I plus plus. So this is the initialization expression of outer for loop. This is the testing expression of outer for loop, and this is the updation expression of outer for loop. Okay? Then let me write inner for loop. Int j is equal to 1, j less than equal to 3, and j plus plus. Okay, j plus plus. Now if I write system dot out dot print ln, let me display the value of I, okay, and a comma within double quotes, then concatenation sign and then j. Okay, j. So this is the outer for loop and this is the inner for loop. Okay, how the execution takes place. Okay, see, I is equal to 1. Okay, I is equal to 1. Clear? I is equal to, okay, I is equal to, where to write? Okay, let me write it here. I is equal to 1. Then the control goes to the testing expression of outer for loop. I less than equal to 3. I less than equal to 3. 1 less than equal to 3? Yes, it is true. It is true. T is true. Okay, try to understand. If it is true, the control will go within the body of the outer for loop. The control will go within the body of the outer for loop. Then we have written j is equal to 1. So j is equal to 1. Okay? What is the condition then? What is the condition? J less than equal to 3. J less than equal to 3 means 1 is less than equal to 3. It is true. If it is true, the control will go within the body of the inner for loop. Then we have displayed the value of I and a comma and the value of J. Assume this is the output display. Okay? This is the output display. Okay, this is the output screen. Okay, what is the value of I? The current value of I is 1. What is the value of the comma j? What is the value of j? The current value of j is again 1. Okay, so 1 comma 1. 1 comma 1. Then the control goes to the updation expression of inner for loop but not outer for loop. Okay, the control will go to the updation expression of outer for loop only if the execution of inner for loop is completely finished. Okay, so j++ means it will become 2. Yes or no? It will become 2. Then the control will go to the testing expression of inner for loop j less than equal to 3. So what is j less than equal to 3? It is 2 less than equal to 3. Answer is true. Yes, 2 is less than 3. Yes or no? Again, control will go within the body of the inner for loop and it will display the value of I and J. What is the value of I? it is 1 only. Okay, it is 1 only. But what is the value of j? What is the current value of j? The current value of j is 2. The current value of j is 2. Okay? Then j plus plus. Okay? J plus plus. Then j less than equal to 3. 3 is less than equal to 3. See, here we have two conditions. 3 is less than 3. 3 is equal to 3. Yes. If it is yes, it means it is true. Okay? If it is true, again it will display the value of I and the value of j. Okay? What is the value of I? It is 1 only. And what is the value of j? It is 3. It is 3. Then, j plus plus. Again, j plus plus. Now, control will go to the testing expression of inner for loop and will check. 4 is less than equal to 3. 4 is less than 3. 4 is equal to 3. So, it is false. Okay? If it is false, the control will what? Go out of the body of the inner for loop, and there is no statement to execute within the body of outer for loop after this. So the control will go to the updation expression of outer for loop. Okay, the control will go to the updation expression of outer for loop. Okay, that is I plus plus. So let me make it 2. Okay, 2. Then the control will go to the testing expression of outer for loop. 2 is less than equal to 3. 2 is less than equal to 3. The answer is true. If it is true, again the control will go within the body of outer for loop. And then the inner for loop will start its iteration once again. So the value of j will become 1 again. Then j is less than equal to 3. 1 is less than equal to 3, the answer is true. So it will display the value of I and j. What is the value of I now? It is 2. So 2 comma, what is the value of j? It is 1. J's value is 1. Then j plus plus, okay, the control will go to the updation expression of inner form, j plus plus. So j plus plus is, it is 2. Then the control will go to the testing expression of inner for loop. 2 is less than equal to 3. 2 is less than 3, yes, true. If it is true, again the value of I and j will be displayed. What is the value of I? It is 2 only. But what is the value of j? It became 2. So here we will get 2 to 1. Okay. Then again the control will go to the updation expression of inner for loop j plus plus. So it is 3. It is 3. Okay. Then 3 is less than equal to 3. 3 is less than equal to 3. Now here we have two conditions again. 3 is less than 3? No. 3 is equal to 3? Yes. If any one is yes, it is true. Okay. Then display the value of I and j. What is the value of I? It is 2 only. And what is the value of j? It is 3. It is 3. Okay. Then again the control will go to the updation expression of inner for loop j plus plus. What is j plus plus? It is 4. So 4 is less than equal to 3. Because what is the condition here? J less than equal to 3. What is the value of j? J is 4. 4 is less than equal to 3. Here we have two conditions. 4 is less than 3. 4 is equal to 3. So it is false. It is false. If it is false, the control will go out of the body of inner for loop. And there is no other statement within the body of outer for loop, so the control will directly go to the updation expression of outer for loop, that is I plus plus. So here we have 3. Okay, here we have 3. Now 3 less than equal to 3. 3 less than equal to 3. Now here we have two conditions. 3 is less than 3? No. But 3 is equal to 3? Yes. So it is true. If it is true, once again, the control will go within the body of inner for loop. And the iteration of inner for loop will start once again. And the value of j will become 1 once again. Then, 1 is less than equal to 3. 1 is less than equal to 3. Yes, true. Display the value of I and j. What is the value of I now? The value of I is 3. The value of I is 3. 3, what is the value of j? The value of j is 1. Okay, then the control will go to the updation expression of inner for loop, j plus plus is 2. Then the control will go to the testing expression. 2 is less than equal to 3. 2 is less than equal to 3. True. Okay, so it will display the value of I and j. What is the value of I? It is 3. Okay, and what is the value of j? It is 2. Then the control will go to the updation expression of inner for loop and j will become 3. Now again, testing expression of inner for loop. 3 is less than equal to 3. Here we have two conditions. 3 is less than 3? No. 3 is equal to 3? Yes. If 1 is yes, the value will be 2. Okay, if it is true, again the value of I and j will be displayed. What is the value of I? It is 3. And what is the value of j? J's value is 3. Okay. Then again the control will go to the updation of expression of inner for loop. J plus plus. It is 4. 4 is less than equal to 3. Now here we have two conditions. 4 is less than 3? No. 4 is equal to 3? No. So it is false. If it is false, the control will go out of the body of inner for loop. And there is nothing within the body of outer for loop. So the control will go to the updation expression of outer for loop i++. Then the control will go to the testing expression of outer for loop. 4 is less than equal to 3? 4 is less than 3? No. 4 is equal to 3? No. It is false. If it is false, the control will come out of the body of outer for loop. And this is the final result. Okay? So, you can see this. This is our output. Okay? These are the values of I. And these are the values of j. These are the values of I and these are the values of j. Now we can say that when the value of I is 1, at that time the value of j becomes 1, 2 and 3. So what can we say? We can say that for each iteration of outer for loop, the inner for loop iterates for n number of times. Okay? Not clear? Okay. You tell me, outer for loop executes for how many times? When I is equal to 1, it executes. Okay? When I is equal to 1, it executes. When I is equal to 2, it executes. When I is equal to 3, it executes. Okay? But when I is equal to 4, it is not executed. So, outer for loop is iterating for how many times? 3 times. And for each iteration of outer for loop, the inner for loop is iterating for how many times? It is iterating for 3 times. Yes or no? Okay? Clear now? So we can say, here the outer for loop is iterating for 3 times. And for each iteration of outer for loop, the inner for loop is iterating for how many times? 3 times. Okay? So we can say, here the outer for loop is iterating. Here the outer for loop is iterating for 3 times. Okay? And for each iteration of outer for loop, the inner for loop is iterating for 3 times. Is this clear? Okay. Clear, huh? Now we will go to the pattern programming. Okay, so I hope you all got the concept of what? For loop and nested for loop, how they work, okay, how they are executed, how the control moves, okay, in which order the control moves, all the things are clear. Now we will go to pattern programming. Okay, let's start. Okay, students, let's start pattern programming. Okay, see, for loop int r is equal to 1. Okay, r less than equal to, suppose let us take 5, sure, 5. Then r plus plus. Okay, let me write inner for loop. For int c is equal to 1, c less than equal to 5, okay, and c plus plus. Okay, so the outer for loop will iterate for how many times? For r is equal to 1, it will iterate. For r is equal to 2, it will iterate. For r is equal to 3, it will iterate. For r is equal to 4, it will iterate. For r is equal to 5, it will iterate. So the outer for loop will iterate for 5 times. Okay? And the inner for loop will iterate again for 5 times. So we can say for each iteration of outer for loop, here the inner for loop will iterate for how many times? 5 times. Okay? Now let me display. Let me write here system.out.print within double quotes. Let me write star. Okay, system.out, it is print, it is not println. Okay, it is not println, it is not println, it is print. Okay, then let me close the bracket. Okay, let me close the bracket of outer for loop. Clear? So this is the block of inner for loop and this is the block of outer for loop. Clear? See, first of all, the initial value of r is 1. Okay, r is 1. The initial value of r is 1. 1 is less than equal to 5. R is less than equal to 5. So 1 is less than equal to 5. The answer is true. Yes. If yes, again c is equal to 1. Okay, c is equal to 1. The control will go to the testing expression of inner for loop, c less than equal to 5. C less than equal to 5 means 1 less than equal to 5. Yes, it's true. So system.out.print star. So suppose this is the output screen. Okay, this is the output screen. Okay, star printed. What is the difference between system.out.print and system.out.println? When we write system.out.println, what does it do? It prints the thing and then takes the cursor to the next line. It prints the thing and then takes the cursor to the next line. Which method? println method. But if we are using just print method, system.out.print method, it will display the thing, but it will not take the cursor to the next line. This is the difference between these two methods. Okay? Okay, so star will be printed and the cursor will remain here. The cursor will remain here only. Okay? Then the control will go to the updation expression C++. C++ means it will be what? 2. Okay? C less than equal to 5. 2 is less than equal to 5. It is T. Then again, one more star will be printed. Okay, then C++ is 3. So 3 is less than equal to 5. Yes, it is true. So if it is true, again one star will be printed. Again C++ is 4. 4 is less than equal to 5. It is true. So one more star will be printed. Okay, then C++ is 5. 5 is less than equal to 5. The answer is true. If it is true, again one more star will be printed. Okay, then C++ is 6. 6 is less than equal to 5. 6 is less than equal to 5. 6 is less than 5. No. 6 is equal to 5. No, it is false. If it is false, the control will go out of the body of inner for loop and we don't have any other statement here. Okay, we don't have any other statement here. So the control will move to the updation expression of outer for loop R++. Okay, so R++ it is 2. Then the control will go to the testing expression of outer for loop, that is 2 less than equal to 5. The answer is true. And again, C value will start from 1 and then C less than equal to 5, 1 less than equal to 5, the answer is true. If it is true, star will be printed here only. Star will be printed here only. Yes or no? Now you apply your mind and tell me, in a single line, after the execution of this statement, this for loop, outer for loop, inner for loop, in a single line, how many stars will be displayed? Let me give you one hint. The outer for loop is iterating for 5 times. And for each iteration of outer for loop, the inner for loop is iterating for how many times? 5 times. So when r is equal to 1, 5 stars got printed. So when r is equal to 2, again 5 stars will be printed in the same line. When r is equal to 3, again 5 stars will be printed in the same line. So, at the end, how many stars you will get in this line? You will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Okay, 25 stars are there. Okay, 25 stars. But my requirement is, after displaying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 stars, after displaying 5 stars, I want the next 5 stars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these 5 stars to be displayed in the second line. For that, before updating the value of r, we will have to write here system.out.println. We will have to write here system.out.println. So what println method is doing? It is not displaying anything. It is just bringing the cursor to the next line. Yes, you can say it is printing a new line. Okay? In other words, you can say it is not printing anything. It is just bringing the cursor to the next line so that the next 5 stars get displayed in the second line. The third set of 5 stars will get displayed in the third line and then fourth line and so on. Is this clear? That is the reason why in pattern programming, within the body of inner for loop, we write print but not printf. Okay? And after the execution of inner for loop and before the control goes to the updation expression of outer for loop, we write a line called system.out.println. Okay, why? To bring the cursor to the next line. Is this clear? So what will happen, you know? When r is equal to 1, 5 times star will be printed. When r is equal to 2, 5 times star will be printed here. When r is equal to 3, 5 times star will be printed here. When r is equal to 4, again 5 times star will be printed here. And when r is equal to 5, again 5 star will be printed here. And when r is equal to 6, it will give false and the control will go out of the body of the loop and we will get this square. We will get this square. Is this clear? So the outer for loop, so we can say, what we can say? We can say, okay, this to be r is equal to 1, r is equal to 2, r is equal to 3, r is equal to 4, r is equal to 5. Here we can say c is equal to 1, c is equal to 2, c is equal to 3, c is equal to 4, c is equal to 5. Okay. So what is the conclusion? The outer for loop is responsible for the number of rows. Okay, how many rows are there? 5 rows. Who is responsible? Outer for loop. But not only outer for loop. Outer for loop along with this system.out.println. Outer for loop with this system.out.println is responsible for the number of rows. And the inner for loop is responsible for the item to be printed. Here the item is star. Yes or no? So to display star, to print star, which for loop is responsible? The inner for loop is responsible. Okay, and since the stars are getting printed, we can say that inner for loop decides the number of columns. Okay, so very very important. What? Very very important. Not the outer for loop. The outer for loop decides the number of rows, whereas the inner for loop decides the number of columns. Okay? In pattern programming, the outer for loop decides the number of rows, whereas the inner for loop decides the number of columns. Okay, note. Very, very important. So in the next video class, we will discuss about other patterns also. This was the fundamental. Please go through it again and practice. Okay. Okay, now let me show the same thing to you in my laptop. Okay,
come. Yes, listen. Let us open BlueJ. Okay. Create a class. Give any name. Okay, double click over it and open. Control A, backspace. PUBLIC, public class pattern. PATTERN, pattern 1. Okay, PUBLIC public, STATIC static, VOID void, main, capital STRING string, array space ARGS. Okay, now for loop, int R. R stands for number of rows. So R starts with 1, yes or no? R is equal to 1, R less than equal to, suppose 5, then R plus plus. Okay, now inner for loop. Int C. C stands for column. Column is equal to 1. C less than equal to 5. And C plus plus. Okay. System dot out dot print. Okay. Let me print one star. Close the block of inner for loop. Then close the block of outer for loop. Close the block of main method. And then close the block of class. Control K. No syntax error. Now here, clearly we can see that we have used print method. Yes or no? We have used print method, but not println. So what will happen? The star will get printed in a single line. All the stars will get printed in a single line. Clear? Now here the outer for loop is iterating for how many times? 5 times. And for each iteration of outer for loop, the inner for loop is iterating for 5 times. Okay. So star, when R is equal to 1, star will be printed 5 times in a single line. Then when R is equal to 2, again star will be printed 5 times. Then when R is 3, again star will be printed for 5 times. So if R is equal to 1 to 5, so how many stars will be printed in a single line? 25 number of stars will be printed in a single line. Yes or no? Okay, see. Listen, let me show it to you. See, 25 stars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Now, what my target is, after printing these 5 stars, the cursor should come to the next line. For that reason, in pattern programming, just after the inner for loop, but within the body of outer for loop, we write system dot out dot println. System dot out dot println. So what is the task of this println method? To take the cursor to the next line. Okay, before the second iteration of outer for loop. Clear? See. Clear? Now, in order to make it appear good, you can give one space after the star. Control K, no syntax error. See. Okay, now it is looking good. Clear? So this is all about today's video. In the other video, I will discuss about other patterns also. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. Bye-bye.